Mucros House was given to the Irish public by a very wealthy American who had bought it for his daughter as a wedding present. The house itself remained closed until the mid-60s, when a group of local business people and the clergy formed a trust. The ethos and the remit was to try and preserve and sustain aspects of Kerry folklife and Irish folklife that would otherwise be forgotten. All of the money that is generated from the profits set from the scarves that you're buying, or the caps or capes, or any of the Mucros products you buy, are put back into the trust. The remit of the trust is to ensure that the crafts, such as pottery, bookbinding, and also the weaving that are here at Mucros, will be sustained. John Cahill is our master weaver. John has been here at Mucros since 1976, so he started here at a very young age. I mean, probably just out of short pants, the truth be known. His appearance belies his age, and John has vast experience with weaving. He qualified as a weaver in Galashiels College outside Edinburgh in Scotland, where he spent 4 years. He's primarily a hand weaver. Now, the looms we use are 200 years old. They're unique. You don't find them too many places anymore. And in fact, if any become available or on the market, which is a rare occurrence, we purchase them and we use them for spare parts. We use the looms. The only difference we would have made to the looms from the looms that we got, these looms when they were used 200 years past, was we have mechanised. So each of the looms has a small electric motor which speeds up the process. The end product is exactly the same. You're getting a uniquely woven product that is individually woven, has what we call a selvage, which is an edging on either side of the scarf to ensure that it doesn't unravel. And furthermore, the weave, because it's done in these hand looms, is a very loose weave. Now, modern day looms can't do that. Principally, they weave wider, but also they weave a lot tighter. You would not be able to tell the difference between our scarf done on a hand loom or on the loom with the electricity. It makes no difference. It just means that we can bring this product to you at a much more affordable price. John is the master weaver here. He's also the designer. He gets his inspiration from the scarves from the Mucros and the beautiful surroundings we have here. We're very fortunate. Mucros is in the centre of Killarney National Park. We're surrounded by 26,000 acres of grassland, mountain, lake, and the beautiful Muckross House itself. And it's easy to see where John gets his inspiration. There's lots of different greens here. There are lots of different purples, and there are lots of different blues. The kind of core colours that we use to give the vibrancy to our scarves. We combine that then with unique premium yarns that we use, that John will select, and that are woven to our specifications.
The range of alpaca yarns, therefore making the alpaca scarves. And here what we have is Suri alpaca as well. All these yarns were imported. We bought them in from Peru, and they're all dyed, again, like Paul was saying, to our colours. Space dyed in any particular colour we want. That's what gives us the range of those. Pebble scarf. This is a boucle yarn, again designed by ourselves to give a kind of a lofty, kind of a hand finish, you can see here.
So you are buying a unique product. We have 6 looms and a warping mill, and the average loom will produce about 30 scarves a day at full capacity. So when we're at full capacity, we would do about 180 looms or scarves a day. They then need to be taken off the loom. Each one needs to be hand tasseled, and some of them would need to be washed just to give them a finish. And following that, then we put on the swing label and the unique Mucros label onto it, and that would complete the process for scarves.